Moises Diaz from Arlington, Texas, and I'll be fighting November 5th, Muay Thai in a cage. I get another chance here, and it's going to be good. Training's going good already, and Andrew's a really tough opponent. We've actually fought before in an MMA bout, and you know that was a pretty good little battle we had. So I'm really looking forward to this fight. I think it's going to be real good for not only the both of us, but the fans are going to be the real winners because they're going to get to see two guys stand in the pocket and slug it out. So I'm looking forward to it. Like the last fight, my second son was born the Tuesday before the fight. So, you know, I was just kind of had a whirlwind of emotions going on back then. But for this fight, you know, I'm clear-headed. Everything is going great. Training camp, like I said, is going good so far. So I'm excited. You know, I think it's going to be a really good fight. Very happy that you guys continue to have me back, you know, since XKO2, which was the first show we put on in front of about 200 people. And now look where we're at, you know. So, you know, thank you guys, Thomas, XKO, and everybody that supports the promotion. I want to thank my family who, you know, as long as they've been saying, you know, when am I going to hang it up? I can't get away. But they continue to support me. Just all the fans for the continuance, the support they keep to continue to give the promotion of XKO. And that's what makes this the best promotion in Texas.
My name is Andrew Sosa, a.k.a. The Brick Wall. I'm fighting Moises Diaz for the second time. Fought him once before in an MMA match. Knocked him down the first time, but he recovered really quickly, which props to him, and he was able to get a choke on me after a takedown because I rushed in too much. So I've always been wanting to face him kickboxing, and that way his wrestling and BJJ won't be able to save him, and I finally get that opportunity, and I'm going to put it on him. I have fought, I believe, like 6 times, if memory serves correct. I fought for XKO. It's my favorite promotion. But now I'm back, and I finally get to participate in the Muay Thai competitions, which I am extremely thankful for. Whenever Thomas told me last year that I was going to be able to fight Muay Thai and they were going to be holding Muay Thai fights, I consider it the hugest blessing and the best opportunity for my career, because years ago I decided that kickboxing was going to be my career, even if it's not as popular, and that's what I truly am going to be the best. I love MMA, and I will always continue to do it, but my specialty is anything striking, and I don't like all the wrestling and everything as much, although I love BJJ. It's just not my thing. Some people are, you know, more akin to other things, and that's just how it is. That being said, I finally get to do what I do best, my specialty, which no one has been able to see me do on professional TV, especially in the USA. So I'm going to absolutely bring the house down with this severe knockout at XKO November 5th.
Ladies and gentlemen, Antonio Burgess joined with Scott Groff here at XKO 33, the Muay Thai fight between Andrew the Brick Sosa.
Brick Wall, not a brick. He's a brick wall.
The Brick Wall.
Brick Wall Sosa.
And Moises Diaz. The funny thing about, interesting thing about Andrew Sosa is that the opponent he's about to fight for the first time in his Muay Thai career is also the man he fought in his first MMA professional fight.
That's right.
Moises Diaz.
That's right. And Andrew Sosa's completely no quit.
Yes.
No quit whatsoever. And he's training with Carlos Moreno, of course, Muay Thai specialist. And Moises Diaz. Moises is, man, I tell you what, this guy does it all. MMA, Muay Thai, father of two. What a wonderful guy. What a wonderful guy. And he's, I tell you, you look at the trunks, not the trunks, but his trunk. He is like, his legs, I mean, those are some grown man athlete legs on Moises Diaz.
You know, he's coming in, he looks so healthy. He looks so crisp, so focused. He's ready to put in work tonight.
Yes, he is.
He's ready to work. Everything in his life is clear. I spoke to him, and he's doing this because he loves the sport. You know, he's in the gym with Eric Flores, He's trained with, I want to say it was Star Gym. And he's just ready to get, this is his passion.
Yeah, Star Muay Thai.
He's so on fire with Muay Thai. We're going to see a never, ever better Moises Diaz.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following professional Muay Thai bout is in the 165-pound weight division, 3 3-minute rounds, is sponsored by Hydro Pros, hydration specialists. Your referee in charge of this contest is Aladdin Martinez. Ladies and gentlemen, fighting out the Jim Ross Law Group blue corner, he's trained in Muay Thai and tonight is making his professional Muay Thai debut. He has a 3-0 exhibition amateur record. He stands 5'11", weighing at 165 pounds. Trained in Siam Star Muay Thai and Louisville Boxing Gym, who he's representing from Dallas, Texas, Andrew Brickwall Sosa. And his opponent, fighting on the Knicks Bank red corner, he's trained in Muay Thai and holds a professional fight record of 0 wins and 1 loss in professional Muay Thai. He stands 5'7 and weighed in at 164 pounds. Representing Arlington Muay Thai and the gym, from Arlington, Texas, Moises Diaz!
All right, so Antonio, here we go. Professional Muay Thai in the cage.
It's crazy how they meet each other, that Moises is faced again with another opponent that he called him out, basically.
Yeah, I mean, that's exactly right. It's like, hey, we're meeting again.
On different terms.
Yeah.
And, I mean, who better than the Brick Wall who's never been knocked out?
Yeah, Sosa is that's the one thing about Andrew Sosa. He is just no quit.
Dude, I mean, he does not stop. And Moises, man, he's ready for blood tonight.
Yeah.
And quick, already off the gate.
Yeah, he very light on the toes, trying to get the jab, working the jab. Watch for the huge leg kicks by Moises.
You know, I trained a couple of days with Moises hitting legs and squats, and I said, man, I'm done. After the third set, I'm done, dude.
Yeah.
I can't keep up with you.
No, dude, I mean, he's grown man legs. Wow. You don't want to get hit by that. Sosa kind of, wow. Sosa better keep those hands up. I'm not sure what Andrew's thinking. I mean, he did a little twirly twirl right there. You know, Muay Thai clinch.
You know, and it's great to see that, you know, they're both back in here meeting for the second time under different circumstances.
Exactly.
Feeling each other out. No takedown. No takedown at all. That's how Moises won against Andrew Sosa. Now that's eliminated. Now it's all stand up, baby.
Yeah, and Sosa's going to have to be really quick on his jab.
Oh! Didn't phase him!
He just said,
didn't even
what
phase
else
him.
You got? Look, he left a mark on his face, and he says, what else you got?
Didn't even. And
what else you got?
Moises knows that
Andrew is tough. Man, Andrew just smiled at him.
I just can't believe you just took a kick from Moises Diaz.
In a flat to the face.
Yeah.
Left a huge red mark. Let me tell you something. Anybody can take that.
And you heard it from way in the back.
It sounded like a gunshot.
Yeah.
That was bone on bone.
Like, did that just happen?
That was awesome.
Unbelievable.
He is a brick wall. Diaz would have knocked 9 out of 10 guys with that.
You know, Moises said this is his passion. He said this is where he wants to begin his career, and this is what he wants to be known for, is his Muay Thai. So MMA may be on the shelf for a long time. You know, Moises, I told him, you carry all your emotion on your face. You have a terrible poker face, Moises. Whatever you're going through, whether it's joy or pain, you can see it. And right now, I see focus.
Oh, yeah, he's focused.
I see very much focus and determination.
He's incredibly focused. I'd like to see him go ahead and work off of his, you know, work off of maybe a one punch or 1-2 punch and then line up the leg kick. Nice body kick.
You know,
another nice body kick. And Moises is like, let me get out of the way of this brick wall for a second.
Right.
Because Sosa, that may not have knocked him out. And he may have been like, what else you got? But what's cracking me up, you know he's feeling it because the entire left side of his face is red.
Right. And so, you know, Rev explained the rules. You know, this is not an MMA fight.
Well, no.
There's a leg sweep.
Understand, in most pro Muay Thai, you can do leg sweep takedown.
Yes. You know, Moises is just giving it a little. Round two. Sosa, Diaz. Sosa took a very flush kick to the jaw.
It just didn't do anything.
Didn't even faze him.
Listen, the entire left side of Andrew Sosa's face is the imprint of Moises Diaz's right foot.
Exactly.
And he laughed about it. And he genuinely didn't care. He didn't faze him. He just doesn't give a rip. He has got one of the hardest heads, be it MMA or whatever. I mean, he just doesn't. And Sosa, that's what Sosa wants to make it dirty.
Yeah.
I mean, he's like, we're gonna throw a lot of the skill set out, and let's just get in here and just scrap.
Now, if you're Moises and you know that he wants to get in the clinch, that's what you got to start doing to score points. You got to do the leg sweep and just throw him on the ground. You know
yeah.
What I mean?
Jeez, that's a big kick.
I think that's going to piss Moses off.
Oh, and Moses, big left hook. He just misses with it.
Right. Yeah, got to watch that crotch kick.
Sosa checking the kick of Moises Diaz. Big body kick by Moises.
You know, we're just waiting for both these guys to let the leather go. Let it go. There you go. Just start peppering it up.
Nice knee. Elad Martinez, good job of separation. And here's the thing. You can see Sosa's just kind of wanting to clinch up and make it dirty.
Yeah.
He doesn't want to do much more than that.
Well, and that's not what Muay Thai was necessarily designed to do.
No, it wasn't. But here's the thing. That's how you keep him off. That's how you keep him off. You went a big straight front kick. Right to the midsection. Nice movement by Moises Diaz. Oh, boy, I heard some cup clashes there.
Yeah.
And you really got to watch out for that. But yeah. Andrew Sosa would do well to just go ahead and let some of those big punches that we've seen him throw in MMA, and just throw those things. Oh, nice elbow by Moises Diaz.
Changing it up.
Boy, that's a really nice elbow. That'll cut you fast too.
And we gotta do more of that, you know.
See, and this is good dirty trench warfare. And it might be boring for a lot of people to watch, but man, it's not a fun place to be. Oh, big body, left punch, Diaz.
Now you see when they're going for those kicks, though. I mean, you go shin to shin, man. Unless you've got that rub down to destroy the nerves and all that.
Yeah, and even then, I mean, it's still going to bruise.
Yeah.
I mean, it may deaden a lot of the pain, but, you know, it's not completely.
I'm not liking the clinch too much. I want to see more mitt work here. You know, more punches. Exchange. You a little dirty boxing.
Well, I'm surprised Sosa hasn't remembered that he can use elbows at this distance.
Right.
Because he's in close enough, he should be using elbows. You know, if you can get a little separation, get the elbows moving.
Got one in before, you know, before you separate. Got one more in there, you know.
As I listen to Antonio Perkins' personal problems in between rounds here.
It can all be solved with the ring of a bell.
And here we are, third round. Sosa in the black and red trunks.
I want to see Moises go off.
Diaz in the white trunks.
Yeah, I want to see Sosa go off.
And right here, you need to.
That's Moses.
Yeah, and look at Andrew Sosa's like, come on, what else you got?
Now, I'm gonna tell you right now, I like the style of this kid, of Sosa, but you got to be careful, man. You take a lot of damage.
Well, that's the thing.
You're not gonna have a long career.
No, you're not. You're gonna be an entertaining guy, but you better make hay while the sun is shining.
Yeah, because you know that punch drunkenness, man. It may settle in when you least expect it. You know.
There you go. And Moses did the right thing. I mean, a good push off, but. Look at and Sosa's like, you missed me, man. I'm not even there anymore.
Right.
I mean, these are two guys. I'm not saying they don't like each other, but there's no love lost.
No. Oh, it was coming.
Andrew Sosa.
It was coming.
Just hit Moises Diaz in the naughty bits.
Yeah, it was. It looked like it might have been coming. You know, tell any fighter to take all the time they need to get 5 minutes.
Yeah.
You know, take all the time you need.
Yeah.
Because when those things get kicked up in there, man, it's not a pretty night. It's not a pretty night. Take all the time you need. You know, when Moses' corner is telling them to breathe, There's no rush to get back in there?
No rush. Make sure your balls are still there, Moses.
They're cradled, but still that cup can still get you rung.
You definitely can ring bells where you don't want bells ring.
You know, Moses, I'll tell you right now, Andrew wants a fight. He wants a fight.
He does. Everything about it. I mean, it's one thing about Sosa. He genuinely loves to just scrap. He likes to fight.
Touch of the gloves, respect. Moses put a couple good combinations together and then...
Whoa! What is this?
That's what you like to see.
What is this?
Boy, I tell you what, that's fun stuff to see right there.
That is what we've all been waiting for.
That's an enjoyable thing.
That's what we've been waiting for.
I mean, both guys just, who can hit you the most?
If that's not on the next highlight reel, that's I'm going to be pretty pissed off.
That was awesome.
Oh, he was ready to connect.
Yeah, he was.
That's like throwing a third strike out in the World Series.
And here, this is where you want to see some. You want to see some elbows.
Oh.
Nice body shot.
Oh!
Big knee.
I'm saying, man, that's what's coming. Get off the clinch and let's
Moses
go.
Diaz putting a big knee in Andrew Sosa's chin.
Moses is awake. You woke the giant, and here he comes.
Oh, yeah, I tell you what.
He is ready.
Yeah, you know, you rung his twins, and, you know, it's like, hey, let's go.
Oh, he checked it, and that's not pretty.
No.
When you check that leg kick.
No, and Sosa doesn't look like he's got a lot left in the tank as far as punching ability.
Right.
But, man,
he used it all in that 50-mile-an-hour punch.
I'm telling you.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, they just throw 50, 60 punches in a row.
Right.
Well, and
they're going. This is all they got. It's got to be something. It's got to be something or nothing. He's tacking him. Yeah, he just yelled at him. Oh, man, you got to love that.
It's Moses Diaz.
Just stop throwing punches.
With about 3 seconds, I put his hands like, what?
Yeah.
With the shit, just what?
Just, I mean, it would have been nice to throw a punch at the very end, but he threw a what? I mean.
He was like, what?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of action, the judges scored it, all three of them, 29-28. Your winner by unanimous decision, Moses Diaz!
Moses, congratulations. I don't know if they can pull the replay back or not. You left your signature on him in the first round with what had to be one of the hardest head kicks I've seen. And he just smiled. But you got a foot imprint on the left side of his face for the whole damn fight. And right here, 3 seconds left, you stood there and screamed at him, let's go. Well, it was a scrappy fight. It was a Muay Thai fight. And then you get the decision. In fact, obviously the only way you're going to knock him down, I guess, was to bring it, let him know the decision. It was a good fight. Andrew, it was a good fight. Listen, terrific stuff. You wanted to really show more of the Muay Thai aspect. You really wanted to make it a street fight.
give me your thoughts on all three rounds besides the nut shot.
The game plan was to come in, try to use just technical Muay Thai. I wanted to take out his leg, his front leg, take it out, so he would be a punching bag. But he did a real good job getting out of the way, avoiding the damage. So we had to kind of just make some adjustments. But I knew he was trying to make it ugly, and the Mexican inside of me wanted to come out and just say, "Fuck it, let's brawl." But I had to listen to my corner. We stayed to the game plan. But as you can see, that last round, those last 10 seconds, I had my hands down. I said, "Fuck it, bring it on. Come on, is that all you got?" So that's how.
I lost the red button on the way up here to bleep it. So, children, he said, go to school, don't do drugs. All right, ladies and gentlemen, listen, Moses, great, great stuff. 1-1 is a pro Muay Thai fighter now. You put on a great show. I'm sure you're going to enjoy watching it again and see what happened. But, folks, one more time for your winner, Moises Diaz.